In this session, we will see how to validate user inputs in the client side and avoid a request being made to the server with invalid information. And as you'd expect, to have client-side validations, we will need to change here the save button, and we will change the validation property to client and server. The input validation is performed in the client side. If the validation fails, a message is displayed and no request is made to the server. If the type values are valid, then a request is made to the server, the screen action of this button is executed, and the validations are run again on the server side. The client-side validations that the platform does are to test if mandatory inputs are filled in and if the values in these inputs are compatible with the data types of the variables used to store their value. So again, let's set a breakpoint here in the debugger. We will make sure that the client-side validations avoid that the request is made to the server. Let me just start here the debugger, and let's publish the changes so that we can test this in the browser. Okay, let's go into the products again, and let's edit our USB camera. And let's remove here the name of the product and hit save. Notice that we have immediate feedback that the field is the required field and we need to fill in this data. And if we go back here into the development environment, you notice that the breakpoint was not hit. The debugger did not stop here in the breakpoint, and that's because the request was not made to the server. Now, let's go back here. If we try to save this product with no name and a negative price, you will see that this validation is performed. This is a client-side validation, it's a mandatory field, but the validation that we added in the server side is not executed, it's not a client-side validation. But if we set here the price to be a data type not compatible with that variable, and we try to save it again, you'll notice that now we will have here an error for this input. It is mandatory and it's not filled in. And this other one has an invalid data type. Now, let's make sure that the validations on the server side are still working. Let's change here the name again, USB camera, and let's add a valid price and a valid price according to the data type, but not according to the logic we added in the server. So let's say here that this is minus 10, save, and notice that this is going to the server now. This is going to the server. See the browser loading the page? This is going to the server. We stopped in the breakpoint, so this means that the client-side validations were performed and were okay, and now the quantity stock is okay, but the product price is not valid, and we're going to invalidate that input, and let's continue the request. And you'll notice here that the server-side validation was performed as well. And that's it.